All right. Interesting enough as well, there was a yellow card for Colby. And my biggest thing, and the reason I'm bringing this up, I know the debate's out there, should have been a red, should have been that. Forget the law, gentlemen. You guys are coaches. And what I want to bring into the table here is that what Colby has done now is everything I've been taught, everything that you get taught as a rugby player. Keep your eyes on the ball. The law says you must look after the safety of the guy catching the ball. And I ask the question again, how does that, when the law changes, how does it impact on the coaching?
Yeah, guys, I've got nightmares, and Johan Ackerman will tell you as well what happened with Quagga there. Now, I've got a thing what they told us, I'm just comparing now. When Quagga went, he took his eyes off the ball and he kept on running. But for me, Robbie, and my dear friend, I don't want to disagree with you. I don't do that often. But I don't think that's red whatsoever because the eyes gave it away. You start with red and then you're looking at mitigating things. What happens now? Now, the very first thing, and you're asking, where was his eyes? On the ball the whole time. And that's why it was yellow. That's why the way I've got it, Robbie.
We've still got to get to scrums, but I'll debate this with you. You as an individual, which in this place was Cheslin's rights, you can say, they've got to protect the player that is in the air. There's no question about the law. All right. If you go back to the law, I understand what your gentleman was saying. I'll take it on board. But that, to me, is a red card. And I know you can agree to disagree within the laws of the game. For me, it's a red card.
Okay, no.
I'm happy. It can be red, can be blue, can be green. I ask the question again. When the law changes,
yes.
What impact does it have on coaching? Cheslin Colby, from when I was a school kid, whatever sport you play, keep your eyes on the ball. He did it. He ran, the ball was coming, it was dipping. He kept his eyes on the ball. Rugby people, the law changes. What impact does it have on coaching?
Yes.
Yes, you're so right.
Eh? I want to take it back to Buckies.
Okay.
Buckies were born to hurt people.
You said it.
With blessings.
With blessings
I've
from
never
me.
Heard that before.
He was there to hurt people. That's the reason why I selected him. So he's going to be hard on you. Whenever you carry the ball, he's going to be in control. If he carries the ball, he will be in control. This is the same thing here. For me as a coach, a player can do anything on the field as long as he just look after the ball. Now, if we have to go look after the opponents too, you know?
And that's what the law. That's what the laws are implicating
at this moment. If I have to go look, should I go high here? Should we kiss? Should we whatever do here? If I have to make those kind of decisions, I'm telling you now, it's gonna be really. And I'm gonna say something bad here.
No, you
the
can't.
Laws has never been changed for the sake of the rugby players. It's been changed for the referees to control it better.
Not for the player's safety.
Ach, you know, in life, this is why you choose to play rugby. I mean, the bigger guy don't want to come down to the level of the smaller guy. The faster guy can't come to the level of the guy who's slower and bigger. So that is the differences that we have in our game. So what I'm saying is that exactly what you said. If the guy is maliciously trying to hurt somebody who's not in control, like in the air there, it's a different story. And that is why referees should have somehow in their life should have played the game somewhere. Because if you look at Cheslin would have jumped for that ball if he wasn't shielded away from the ball with a guy on the ground. Ne? So he would have gone for that ball. That's why he knew he lost the aerial battle from distance where he were.
I disagree. I think it was dipping as well. His eyes are on the ball. There's no need to jump.
He knew it. But if he wasn't stopped there with his speed, he would have contested the ball in the air, just if you can look at it again. But the one thing is, I agree with you. There's no way that I can teach a player. That guy there, what?
Colin Murray.
Was it Murray or is it?
It's Conor Murray.
Going isn't it bigger?
Up. No, bigger no, is next to him.
If he had his eyes on the ball, did he see this player, yes or no?
Well, well,
but that's not what I'm going to coach.
You coach peripheral viewing.
Yeah, so that's not what I'm going to coach.
What's wrong with you, coach?
You understand, Swayze? That's not what I'm going to coach my player.
No, you don't want to coach.
I want to coach my player. Keep your eyes on the ball. That's what everything
you talk.
I don't say keep your eyes on the ball, then look at the opposition.
Robbie said it. We got to coach within the law. You know, if you're a poacher, you got to know what is the law. Hurting them or not hurting them, but you got to do it in the law. Now, if we've got Ibn Etzebet, he's our fridge, he's our toughie, but he's got to do it within the law. So